It was the penultimate episode of The Twilight Zone last night, starring Chris O'Dowd as the character Jeff. The blue scorpion found him in a way that had detrimental effects on his life. However, how did the story pan out? And how does it compare to the other stories that the season's given us? Well, let's find out. Before I go ahead, make sure you go over to my Twitter, @brainpilot_, and tweet me what show or movie you'd like me to review next. So without further ado, I'm Brain Pilot, and here is a review of The Twilight Zone, The Blue Scorpion. Just to let you know, this video will contain spoilers, so watch with caution. So the episode started with Chris O'Dowd, and it revolves around a gun called the Blue Scorpion that he came in contact with when his father killed himself with it. Along with this, he found a bullet with the name Jeff on, and a suicide note that stated, "I loved him more than you." Within the first 5 to 10 minutes, this episode of the show did have a different feel to what the previous ones in the seasons had. It didn't feel so deliberate in the way in which that it was forcing a social commentary issue on me. As the episode goes on, you hear how the gun is priceless, and that you don't find the Blue Scorpion, it finds you. Along with this, Jeff comes in contact with many people with the same name as him, leading you to believe that the bullet could be for any one of them. But obviously, you think that he's going to follow in his father's footsteps, seeing as though the gun went off a couple of times on its own, especially with the myth of the reputation that the gun has. It all leads you to believe that he's going to shoot himself. At one point, after arguing about divorce settlements, you see Chris O'Dowd's character state the line to his ex-wife, "I love him more than I ever loved you." In my opinion, the line felt a little deliberate in the story, and I don't feel as though the narrative had been developed that much. 2 minutes prior to that statement, he was saying how he loved his wife loads and that he wanted her back. To me, it just didn't align well. The main focus was the gun being able to make his troubles all go away. And technically, in the end, it did. But in a different way to what was expected. He ended up killing a home invader outside his old house who was obviously called Jeff. And it turned his life around. He didn't lose any assets in his divorce, he received an award at the college he worked at, and he finally moved on. It was a twist in the story that I didn't expect, but if I'm being honest, I didn't really feel the impact of it. It felt like it was building and building and building, and then it just fell flat. It's annoying because up until then, I was relatively hooked on the actual episode. Ultimately, Jeff receives the box again, just like at the start, with the gun as evidence, but he throws it in the sea. At this point, we see a young boy find the gun, and personally, if I'm being honest, I don't know how he even saw it because it was so far away. But of course, it had his friend's name on the bullet, highlighting that this deadly, vicious cycle is going to happen all over again. It was a relatively interesting story that had me engaged with it. But the story developed too much when compared to the pacing of the episode. Maybe it needed a longer runtime. I would have liked to have seen more relationship building with the gun and literally seeing him being driven to the point of insanity. But I just didn't get that, which is a shame. The characters. Chris O'Dowd played the main character Jeff. In my opinion, I think Chris O'Dowd's performance has been one of the best in the entire season of the show. The emotion that he gave in his character and the way that he was able to translate it across the screen was perfect. You felt scared when he did, you felt nervous when he did, and you never knew which direction he was going to go with the relationship with the gun. He delivered a character that was likable and allowed the viewer to be engaged with him. I didn't expect anything less from this actor or the performance. It was great. There weren't really any other characters in the show that I would feel had enough screen time to warrant a rating of their performance. The rest of the cast were okay. They were fine. Final thoughts. Overall, I would say that I did enjoy this episode. As I said, the ending probably wasn't the best that it could have been, and I would have liked it to have struck a chord with me more. It feels like they thought of the concept, but didn't really allow the time to be able to write a good ending for this episode. Visually, it was really nice on the eye, as per usual. But that doesn't make it any better of an episode. There's something about it, even when I'm watching that first few minutes. The moment the music starts and Jordan Peele's voice comes in, it gets me. Every time. at least it manages to do that. It's worth the watch because it is definitely one of the reboot's best episodes. So go and watch it. Next week's episode does look very good, and I'm interested to see what The Blurry Man is about. I'm hoping the show is going to go out on a high, and they're saving something really good for the end. What did you think of this episode? Did you enjoy it? Leave a comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you next time.